Hello, crafters. This is Raquel with Paints and Glitter, and I'm coming along to do a quick unboxing of one of the orders that I placed from the vault. It is going to be the first order, however, there are more coming my way, and I wish they would send them all out at once, but that's not how life works, right? So I'm just coming along to open up the box. Let's see what I got. Let's see here. So, some cardstock. If you've not tried the classic card from Tonic Studios, just to let you know, it's so pretty. It's got a really pretty linen weave on one side, and then it's smooth on the other. This one was a very, very low rock bottom price, and it's called Oyster Gray. I hadn't tried their gray yet, so I wanted to see what that was like, and I like it. It's a really pretty neutral. So I like it. It'll be great for card bases. And oh, by the way, that is 80 pound and it's 8.5 by 11 sheets. And there's a total of 10 in the packages when they are the classic card. Specialty cards are a little bit less per package. I also got a Nouveau Glitter Drop. And this one, the color is Aquatic Mist. I love the color, it's very pretty. I had been wanting this. I had had this on my wish list for a very, very long time, and it kept coming in and out of stock, in and out of stock, and it came back, and I figured if I don't get it now, I probably never will be able to find it on the site, as it happens with many items that I like. They just sell out quickly, and this is meant to be used in the mini albums, so if you know, if you've been to this channel before, you know I love making mini albums. It's my favorite craft. And this is called Remember That First, dot, dot, dot. And it's Memento Keeper die set. So this is meant to make like a little notebook almost that you can place either inside of a mini album as you see here, which is really cute because I think here, yes, they use the twist and pop mechanism to make it look like this, which I don't have. However, I think I could probably come up with one. And then over here, you see the entire thing in this one picture. So hopefully you can see that. But it obviously has panels, just like all of the other dies from Tonic Studios. They always have little panels that you can fit inside of what you make to decorate it and make it look really pretty. This one has one that has a flower and leaf motif that's so pretty. And then it has one with a more open leaf. So that's kind of curious, because very interesting. Anyway, whatever. Very cute. It has a total of 36 dies, which I'm surprised by. But we'll get into that later. And then there's this kit, one of the few that I got, because it was at a phenomenal price, could not pass it up. So this one is actually, let me see which one it is, I don't remember. Oh, so this is one that came with the actual folder, so I'm super excited about that because I needed one. Not all of them, it's every 3 months that you get a folder, but all of the kits come with this little wallet which holds the dies. And this is the one with the country apron. It's so cute. This was number, let's see, does it have a number? Okay, so this must be when they stopped putting the numbers on the kits. But it came with a sticker. Always cute. So you can put it on the front and that way you know which kit you have. It came with stamps. And the stamps look like this. And it is a baking theme, so it says baked with love, thanks a bunch, just for you, happy Mother's Day, which I'm really happy about, grandma's kitchen, from the kitchen of, dot, 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 and it's kind of like in the shape of a little pie, I think that's cute, your special day, happy Father's Day, which is wonderful, from the garden of, and it's your day, and then it has two leaves, two flowers. And they're quite small and they're meant to be that size so that they can obviously fit the dies. But you can make a little box with this. And some of you may have already seen this, but there's a sample. So cute. Where am I? Over here. It's so darling. Okay, so there's the dies are, oh wow, okay. I don't even remember this set, guys, because it's been so long. But as you can see here, there's the size of the apron. Let me measure it four and, what is this? Let me see here, four and 3/8 inches tall. And it is 3 1/4 inches wide. And then it has the panels here so that you can place it inside of the little apron, which also has the little holes so that you can put the little string that would tie around the neck, but you can also use the die that you see here. But it has one that will give you a scalloped edge that you can use. It has the one with the stitched edge, which is the base, and then it has one with a smooth edge. And then it does have the layering piece here that you can use that has, it looks like stripes. It has the pocket. So cute. The pocket has a scallop edge, and then it has a layering piece for the pocket. It has flowers here with two shadows for the flowers. And it has all of the utensils you would find in a kitchen. They're so cute. And what I love about this is that there are two sizes of pockets here, which I think is pretty clever. There's this larger pocket, which of course would fit any of those utensils. They're so cute. Spatula, spoon, smaller spatula, the rolling pin, the whisk, the other spatula. I call them all spatula, can you tell? And then the prongs, the yeah, I forget. Anyway, and the big fork. So cute. Anyway, and I love that it has also the tools in case you want to make a work apron. So this is what I really liked about the set, was that it doesn't have to be an apron that you use in a kitchen. It can be one that, you know, say someone in your life likes to barbecue, then it has the mitt, and then it has the obviously kind of like the barbecue tools, but then it has scissors, it has other tools like wrench and screwdriver, hammer, and then you can do it as a gardening apron. So it has the little trowel and the little fork, I'm gonna call it. But it also has two leaves, two small flowers here, and then the side, this panel here, is so that you can create the box. So cute. And it has a smaller pocket, so you don't have to use the wider one. Oh, I'm so excited. I'm so happy I got this. It's so cute. Okay, so along with that, it came with fired brick glitter marker. It doesn't want to let it out. Here we go. Okay. So I've got a swatch of paper here. So of course you have to pump this. Pump, 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 pump. I sound like I'm being rough on the marker, but it's actually necessary so that you see the ink flowing there. Come on, baby. We want to see your color. Okay. Ooh la la. Magnifique. Look at that color. Ooh, it is intense. Look at that. So pretty. I didn't expect that color to come out of this. Even though it's got a little window and it's called fire brick. I don't know why. That is beautiful. That's really nice. I like that. Okay. Moving along. It's got more Nouveau product, which you get with every kit. And by the way, if you're not a subscriber of the Tonic Craft Kits, you would have to wait for the vault to open to buy a one-off, if they're available, because it is one, you know, first come, first serve. However, you run the risk of missing out, of course. And the other thing is that if you're not a kit subscriber, you don't get the 10% off. Now, because I am, then I get 10% off of every purchase I make at Tonic Studios. And I think it's very worthwhile, because every now and then, you also get another little sale that they might have going on. You know, it's worthwhile. Okay, so Nouveau Glitter Accents. So pretty. I already have this one. This is in Winter Cranberry. And it is a super beautiful color. Let me sample, swatch this one out. So that way you can see. Oh, so pretty. So this, by the way, will dry as a nice drop of glitter. It looks cloudy initially. And you can see here kind of different ways that you can use it. The tip is wider to allow the glitter to come through. And hopefully you can see that there maybe. But it does have a gorgeous shine. Very, very pretty. I like it for the intricate pieces that you can color in or flowers. There's another, and by the way, this is full size. That's another thing I love about Tonic Studios is that when they give you items in their kits, it's not everything is a sample. You do get some full-size product. This one, by the way, is a dream drop. And these are my favorite in the whole collection because they have a pearlescent finish. And this is Lemon Twist. Oh, so pretty. I don't think I have this one. Pretty sure I don't. Yeah, I don't think I have this one. It's so pretty. Oh my gosh, gorgeous. Yeah, totally loving that. I don't know if you can see it, but it will dry with that dome and then it dries with a pearlescent finish. Gorgeous color, and even the bottles are pretty. See that? They're so elegant. That's what, I love that. Oh, and I guess I should swatch this one. We're already for a little bit already, but just to show you what that one looks like. It also has kind of this clear base, but then it has all of that beautiful teal glitter. And once it dries, that cloudiness goes away. But look at those two colors together. It's so pretty. Oh my gosh, I love it. So then there is this one, which is a sample size. Let's set this aside for a second. This is a sample size of chalk mousse, and it is delicate blue. That's exactly what it looks like. Something like, you know, you would use maybe in a baby book. It's described where it gives a chalky finish. They do come covered like that. So once you open it, you want to remain, you want to keep it from getting dehydrated. So you just want to cover it with maybe some Glad press and seal or a piece of saran wrap and then close it. However you want to do that, but it's a good idea to keep it from drying out too quick. So the next nouveau product here is shimmer powder in Catherine Wheel. That's interesting. Catherine Wheel. And it looks like it's red with some orange in it. So I'm going to just sprinkle a tiny little drop here to get to see a sample of that. And you have to be a little bit careful with this product because it does have mica. Woo! Okay, well, that's a lot. Mica flakes in there. And the cool thing about it is that you can just add water if you like. You can add other inks if you like. You can add alcohol to it. You can spritz it like I'm about to. And look at what happens. Ha ha ha. How fun is that? And then the more water you add, I'm going to be able to actually use a little bit of this on a separate piece of paper. I'm going to share with you. Pick up the color from this one because it'll give me a little bit more control there. Maybe, maybe not. Maybe I need to wet this one. There we go. Okay. So then I'm going to be able to transfer some of that. And this, ooh, it has copper in it. I like that. So it's got red, it's got copper. And the more you wet it, the more you can kind of manipulate it, play around with it. Oh, but it's so pretty. It's got gorgeous color in it. And then it's got this surprising shine that comes through. It's kind of hard to see here. But it does have copper coming through. Oh, it's so pretty. So, so pretty. Maybe here you can see some of that copper. Hopefully you can see a little bit of it. I'm trying to hold it so that the light will hit it without creating glare here. But in any case, wonderful for backgrounds, for papers that are already textured. Oh my gosh, absolutely gorgeous. Okay, so that again was Catherine Wheel. Moving along here. After I made a mess. Oh, and it got on my nails. Oh well. Let me clean that off. Always keep a paper towel nearby. And my shirts always get damaged, but that's okay. Oh, I have these. So this is Prism Pink. Look at those sequins. So pretty. It's got the cutest color. And I just made a card, and I'm pretty sure I just used these. So, look like on a card. See the background there? I did this with some other Nuvo products, and I did add some sequins here and there. And they just give that little hint of shine that's so pretty. Oh, and I used them on that butterfly there. So I really like the fact that you can use these on your projects, whether it be shakers or not. And the fact that they come in different sizes, even within the same bottle, is something that I love. So here's, you see the different sizes there, and the color is so pretty. Can you tell I like it? Oh, it's so cute. Okay. I get excited over these things, but I love the size, full size bottle. There's a ribbon, and this one is 1/8 of an inch wide, and it's 16.4 feet. Plenty of it. So that's very, very pretty. And the color is chili red, which matches that spray. Now I can house my little wallet in here and be nice and organized. I can put my little sticker on my kit. Gonna maybe put this in here first. If I want to purchase the magnets from Tonic Studios, I can do that. And then that way I can stick in here the dies, whichever way I like. And then I can, of course, put my little name to my wallet here, Country Apron. That way I know what's inside. So cute. Last but not least, I have the papers that came with this kit. And I do need the names, so I'm just going to quickly go through this. So pretty. Oh my gosh, the colors. So there is this one here, which is a pearlescent card in Princess Pink. So very pretty. And it's, of course, the same color on both sides. And this one, by the way, measures 11.5 inches. Actually, it's more like 11 3/5. 11 5/8 by 8 1/4. Smooth card in ivory white. It's also big enough, 11 3/4 inches long by 8 1/4. That's great for the base of a box, because this is nice and heavy. And that, by the way, this is 300 GSM, so it's perfect for boxes. There's this blue, it's so pretty. And this is classic card in cornflower blue, again with the weave on one side, smooth on the other. Ooh, there's, oh wow. This is beautiful. I've never seen a paper like this. Wow. I made some ruby slippers with Tonic Studios cardstock, but that paper was not this paper. I wish I had had this paper when I made those. It's so beautiful. What is the name of this? So, Scarlet Organza. And this is called Mirror Card. I have to tell you, I've never seen a paper like this. It's so, like, there's a richness to it. Hard to describe, but so gorgeous. Here's yet two more of the classic papers. So, of the classic cardstock, there's these three. So, it's the cornflower blue, the coral pink, and the cherry red. Those are those three. Very pretty. There's this other pearlescent card in ivory sheen, and it hints toward yellow, which is probably why they added the pearls, the dream drops. Very same color. So another wonderful thing about Tonic Studios is the little items that they make from the Nuvo range to complement your projects are going to match exactly. That is super duper awesome. Then the gold, Ooh la la. Gold Dust is the name of this cardstock. And if you haven't seen the sparkle spray in Gold Dust, it is divine. Just to let you know. If you're making something for a wedding, I highly recommend it because it's so classy. It's not chintzy or cheap looking. Then this is specialty card in powder blue lace. It looks like wallpaper. Do you see how it's picking up the light? Oh, it's so beautiful. And it has the most subtle pattern of little, it's almost like little daisies and roses. Oh, it's so pretty. So, so pretty. Then there's this one. This is one of the handmade papers. And this one is a specialty card in pink petal. So pretty. All of those roses. And this is deeply embossed. So you want to, when you cut it, you want to use, I would recommend the larger dies to cut this one, because you don't want to lose any of that fabulosity. That's a word. I don't know. I just made it up maybe. Then two fun pattern card stocks. And by the way, all of these are quite long, just so you know. So you can make more than one card if you're a card maker. And this is almost 12 inches long by, let's see here, 8.5. Okay, so they don't skimp on the sizes of the paper. And of course, these two here are country apron pattern sheets that were exclusive to this kit. They've not re-released these patterns, but it is double-sided. So you get either the little dots or the little flowers, which are so pretty. So I look forward to playing with this kit and coming up with some cute little makes. I hope that you've enjoyed this video. I'll be back with more, as always. And I can play along with some of the dies and all that good stuff and share with you what I've made. If you like this type of content, be sure to give it a thumbs up and a subscribe if you want to come back and watch more. Use my links in the description bar of this video if you'd like to support this channel. All it does is allow me a small commission for the purchases that you will be making anyway. And it helps me make better content on my channel, which I hope that you do come back to watch. And I'll see you in my next video. Be inspired and be blessed. Bye-bye.